You are a businessman. Lately your business is not making any profits and is running under loss. Your powerful friends have abandoned you. Your wife runs an NGO that takes care of about 100 orphan children. These children, who are aged between few months old babies to 15-year-old boys, are rescued and rehabilitated with the aid of donations. These children include both boys and girls. In recent days, your wife is finding it difficult to provide food, education, and other basic necessities such as clothes, shelter, etc. on a regular basis due to lack of sufficient inflow of funds. She wants to close the NGO and hand it over to government. Even though she cares about these children, she is helpless in continuing her NGO on her own. Say what options she has in this situation, in case you would want her to continue to run her NGO. Evaluate their merits and demerits. Answer. The case study emphasis about the empathy, compassion and sense of responsibility of my wife towards the children and society, and she is trying to improve the lives of these children by providing them a better life. The ethical dilemma which is bothering the lady are the lack of financial resources versus duty, love and affection towards the children. The stakeholders are me, my wife, children. The options which are available to her to ensure that NGO is still run by her are: she can approach bigger NGOs which can take over this NGO, and with her still playing the motherly role to the children. This approach will ensure that the children have shelter, food and other needs met, and they have a decent life, especially when sexual exploitation of child is rampant. However, my wife might not be able to play a greater role or role she intended to. She could wait till my business resurges. Then she need not depend on others for funds, as I can help, but as my business is already in losses, it might take some time for it to make profits again, and so much time is not available for the NGO to sustain. She can take help from government authorities or elected representatives of the constituency. This can ensure some funds to the sustenance of NGO in short term. However, the response by the government authorities can be to transfer in the power of NGO to some others. So her purpose is unresolved. She can take help from established industrial houses or companies. As corporate social responsibility is actively being done, there are chances her genuine interest might be understood and funds could flow. However, businesses invest when they have some returns for the investment they make. She can use the influence of social media to explain her cause. This initiative can reach wider audience and ensure greater response. However, the response is still doubtful, as in the age of cybercrimes rising, many people could have doubts to trust a stranger. She can use the above option. Instead of focusing only on funds, she can even concentrate on food items, clothes donations from the society. This can ensure basic needs of the children are met. But this option is not sustainable, as ultimately funds are required for functioning of NGO. There is need to experiment with two, three options simultaneously, like approaching corporates, using social media, etc. for the effective functioning of NGO by my wife.